Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Friday, SpaceX finally launched the Falcon Heavy USSF 52 mission on their 95th mission of the year.
One, engine full power, and liftoff of Falcon Heavy, go USSF 52.
The boosters which launched this mission, B-1064 and B-1065, both landed successfully for the fifth time on the landing pads at landing zone 1 and 2.
You heard that call out and you can see on your screen that the engines have reignited.
Landing leg deploy.
Let's watch as the side boosters touch down for landing.
Stage 2 is in terminal guidance.
Following that, also on Friday, SpaceX launched their 96th and final mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 636. The booster which launched this mission, B-1069, then landed successfully for the 12th time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
With no more launches until next year, we can hopefully expect to see the next couple of missions in the first week of 2024. The Starlink 79 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday, January 3rd at 2:13 a.m. UTC or Tuesday, January 2nd at 9:13 p.m. EST. Following that, later in the day, we could also see a custom mission launch on a Falcon 9. The Ovson 3 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 3rd at 8:46 p.m. UTC or 3:46 p.m. EST. I wanted to share this cool infographic that was posted about SpaceX's launch cadence over the years. It says you can see how flight-proven boosters light green have grown as a percentage of SpaceX launches. They have been reflown 19 times now, something industry incumbents used to think would be impossible. Musk responded to this and said, and if all goes well, SpaceX total launch mass to orbit will increase approximately 50% next year, not including Starship. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the SpaceX sign being installed at the entrance to the test site. Earlier in the week, SpaceX did some GSE testing at the orbital launch site. Another new tank was seen delivered to Starbase for the orbital launch site. The barge carrying the launch tower segment was seen arriving in port. Here's a view of the production yard with work continuing atop Mega Bay 2. The groundwork for the Star Factory expansion is continuing also. Here's a view of the progression on the expansion of the Star Factory building. In response to some information about SpaceX aspiring for one Starship built per week, Musk posted some information. He said, the Super Heavy booster can be used more frequently than the ship as it returns in about 6 minutes and can theoretically be ready for reflight in an hour. The ship needs to complete at least one orbit, but often several, to have the ground track line back up with the launch site, so reuse may only be daily. This means that ship production needs to be roughly an order of magnitude higher than booster production. To achieve Mars colonization in roughly 3 decades, we need ship production to be 100 per year, but ideally rising to 300 per year. On Friday, SpaceX did a double static fire test with both Ship 28 and Booster 10, and here's the Ship 28 static fire test. With the two static fire tests that SpaceX did during the week, they posted this video of the Ship 28 test. They said, ignition of a single Raptor engine on Flight 3 Starship, demonstrating a flight-like startup for an in-space burn. The first resident of the Mega Bay 2 structure, Ship 29, was moved over there from the High Bay. As mentioned, SpaceX not only static fire tested Ship 28 on Friday, but they also performed a static fire test of Booster 10. Elon Musk posted this cool picture of Booster 10 undergoing a full static fire test. He said, just completed static fire test of Flight 3 Super Heavy booster. SpaceX also posted this cool video of the Booster 10 static fire test. Taking a look at the Cameron County website, SpaceX have a couple of dates. They currently have possible closures on both Wednesday 3rd and also Thursday 4th, possibly for some more testing. In addition to that, they also have a temporary road closure for Tuesday 2nd. Booster 12 was seen rolling out of the Mega Bay and over to Massey's test site to begin its test campaign. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.